Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. We're looking for Ruby. We tried to commune with the wind. For some reason, that didn't work. Does this guy have anything else to say?
Hello! Isn't this a fine morning?
So you haven't seen anyone around, Kim asks. A day off. Yeah, still telling the truth. Alright, we're gonna need to look up around here. What about this? The faded remains of a poster with the date 46. A name is faintly legible. Arno van Eyck. Now that we've uncovered that thought, we're finding random posters around. Speaking of which, I'm saving that. We have 45 minutes left on this opioid antagonist dot. I suspect it's something I'm not going to keep, but it's quick, so we'll get it out of the way. Should I just look around in here? And we need to really look everywhere, don't we? Nothing. This is where where we found the dead man. Taken him away. That's a sad thing, really. Apparently he was drunk and fell and killed himself. That's the church. Maybe that's this lady in here? Like I said, we've been in here, but I haven't asked her. Maybe I can ask what's his name as well, who hangs up in the rafters. I forget his name. Juan, I think?
Yes, what is it?
Suna, yeah. She doesn't look up from the keyboard. Have you seen anyone suspicious, say, a woman named Ruby? What? No. No one suspicious around here. Jama says she has not seen her sire, 'tis true. About that 2mm hole again. The swallow, you mean? She looks up, slightly irked. What about it? I've asked all that stuff. Never mind. Can we talk to this guy again? I don't know how to get a hold of him, but he's crawled up out of sight. Kim said we could rule this place out, but we're already here, so might as well check stuff. Oh, never mind. Want to leave. Thing over here, okay. I've talked to the Raver Anadic people lately. Let's go further north. This place we couldn't get into here. Couldn't get in here before. An old door, worn by elements, guards the depot. The wind has blown a sand dune in front of it. The door hasn't been opened in a long while. You see a handle. Could this structure have been used to take the shot? From here to the whirling? I can't see how. Kim looks southeast and blows on his fingers. The church is in the way. Interfacing is very low. What if I put the chain cutters? I'd say chain cutters would help. that cannot be retried. Never mind. Oh wait, that's not it. I'm looking for the multi-tool, yeah. I need to listen to dance music right now. Maybe at a later date. If I were a ruby, where would I hide? So this can't support human weight, we thought. I haven't checked this recently, have I? Four things, yeah. What? The boardwalk rises to your south. It casts its long shadow over you. Well, that's nice. We were just there. This doesn't really help us. So that's the church. This is the Feld building. This is the other building. There's a building here. I can't pass behind the church. Let me just... I wish I could zoom out more, actually. There are some more buildings south of the fishing village. Oh wait, well, that's my crashed car, isn't it? Oh no, that's their tent. Never mind. I don't think she'd be in there. Endurance says, "You see that seagull up there? Remind you of anybody?" No one comes to mind. You! You and the seagull are just alike. Why am I like a seagull? Think about the seagull's story. It's one of endurance and adaptation. The seaside was paradise once. They were birds of that paradise. Then their paradise became Crap City, and what did they do? They became urban survivors, eating burgers out of trash cans, killing and eating pigeons. No time for that sentimental bullcrap. They're hustlers getting crap done. They're one pair of track pants away from gangsters, just like you. Hold on. Have I ever eaten a burger out of the trash? You have. The body remembers. Alright, well, whatever it takes to survive, I am the seagull. Well, that helped. Healed my health of 0. And morale plus 1. Own it! Steal hot dogs, crap in the sand, whatever it takes to keep going. Just in case you guys are wondering, I do censor myself because if YouTube hears me cursing, they might... like make my video with limited ads because of swear words, unfortunately. So I try to keep it to a minimum. Wait. Relax. It's not yours. You didn't crash every MC in Revachol. Hopefully. Okay, so there's this building. This is the... That's the Feld building, and this is the other building. Right? We can't get in either of them. Right, okay. Can't go that way. We have to go around. I'm looking for her. Going around. Fishing village. Let me try in here. There was just this kid in here. I doubt Ruby's in there. But maybe this kid has seen her. Hello, mister. The net picker's daughter waves at you. Do you know anyone named Ruby? I know I had a thought over my head, too. Luby. Luby. Suddenly the girl gets all serious and leans in, as if she's about to tell you a secret. My mom tells me that I'm a big girl, but she doesn't know that I can't say L. Or like, sometimes I can, but then I say L. Kids. Lieutenant shakes his head. Armored gloves. I've been to that before. Where are the gloves now? I hid them. We took them already. I think. Inland Empire says, is that the phasmid? It looks like the phasmid leaning against the wall. And Reaction Speed says, wait. What if this is the fishing rod situation all over again? Try to sneak up to the phasmid. Inland Empire says, it's not the phasmid, it's not even organic. It's a fire iron. How disappointing. Of course that wasn't the phasmid. It's way too big. Don't be too hard on yourself. You couldn't have known that for sure. And besides, finding this phasmid is your special destiny. You can feel it. Give the dream of discovering the Insulindian phasmid a rest, for now. All right. We're not finding Ruby. Maybe we can ask these people. There's also these buildings. Like, what about here? Can we get in there? Can we look in there? What is this building? Doesn't look like we can interact with it in any way. Running over there. Okay, let's talk to these people. I have to run all the way around. Death spiral? Whatever.
Tequila sunset.
He nods in appreciation. Have you seen a red-haired woman named Ruby around here lately? Can't really remember seeing any woman after losing my keys. Trauma says he really has no idea who this Ruby is, sire. Huh. Could you and your pals sign this document? What's it about? He waves his hand apathetically. Ah, I'll let my hand address the situation. Maybe you've heard. I used to be a very successful businessman. I've signed more than a few lease forms or whatever the hell they were. He looks around. Anyone's got a pen? The pro's gonna do it. I have this blue oblong pen. Alright. He grabs the pen and paper from your hands and, very carefully, scribbles on the dotted line next to Lillian Carter, Idiot Doom Spiral. Can I have the pen back, too? Oh! Don't know if I've mentioned it, but I used to be a businessman, and as a businessman, I'm gonna have to keep the pen for my trouble. He nods confidently. Damn it. Interfacing says, no, that was my favorite thing of all the things you have. This had better been worth losing the pen for. Hand-eye coordination says my favorite was the gun he lost. Ah, fine. You've done a great service to the community, to the RCM, and to Revachol. Hey, guys! I'm a hero! He hands you the envelope and waves his hand erratically at his companions. So we have another pen, but do we lose the pen that Kim gave us? I forget which Penny gave us. Hell yes, Rosemary, the red-nosed drunk brings his hand up to his head for salute. The incapacitated drunk lays there snoring like an ancient rusting tractor. Thank you for your help, Kim turns to you. Should we go and mail this? I think I saw a mailbox on Plaza. I want to ask these guys a couple things first. No, I'm done with that.
The legend! He's back and thirsty! I got smokes and piss and a little speed to spice things up.
That's okay.
Danko.
The drunk man speaks in his sleep. Drool dribbles from the left side of his mouth and down his jacket lapel. Hey, wake up! There's no waking him from his stupor. His mind is elsewhere. Alright. Is this enough? I guess this is enough, according to... Get two signatures, that's all we needed. Is Idiot Doom Spiral really a good signature, though? I mean... Is that the guy's legal name, or what? I really don't know. Alright. Are you drinking that? Before I go that way... Oh, right. I can't go further than this for some reason. I can't even walk. Can I walk over this way? I mean, I've probably already been here. Yeah, that's where this all is. Alright. Right? The two buildings. Just want to make sure I'm not missing anything. Yeah, the two buildings. Okay, that's the second one. Let us head south. There are a couple shacks. I've been in one of them. Can we ask these kids? We really couldn't interact with them before. They only cared about their rocks. Gruffy-haired little boy kicks a stone while the other watches him do it. Kids, have you seen any bad people around? One of the twins looks up, his mouth slightly open. What bad people? He asks. Kim says, I don't think questioning four-year-olds without their parents present is going to crack the case. Authority says, then we're definitely doing it. You must be Lillian's twins. This one doesn't say anything, kicking the concrete with his worn-out sneaker. Lily's our mom, explains the other one, tongue still lolling out of his mouth. The stone kicker laughs suddenly. His head is too large for his shoulders. The other one laughs as well. Rhetoric says, wow, so intellectually stimulating. Physical instrument says, the stone kicking isn't even a very high caliber. Anyone could do that. Is little Lily your sister? Yes. 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 That's in. You're being laconic about it? Doesn't look like he knows what that means. I actually don't know what that means. Laconic. Alright, let's head south, because I've looked everywhere north. Look at that, though. Swings. Right, in here. We've been in here. There's another shack up there. It is nothing in here. Oh, where we just came from, down here. What's this? What's that? The shot couldn't have come from here. Trees blocked the way. Well, I'm looking for Ruby. No trouble getting up through that fence. Check back here for anything. No. I can walk in there. No, nothing in there. Is this a structure? Yeah, it's a structure. It kind of looks like a wall, but it's actually a structure. But I need to get into any and all structures possible. I can walk. Can I walk this way? No. So where are we? Here. What about on the other side of all this? Can we go that way? I couldn't find her. Here again. Alright. If she's up here, she's very good at hiding. Unless we can get this gate open at some point. I don't know. Okay, I had to turn off the music. Oh, this is a check we can try again. Close, I think?
The shine on those sunglasses lasts a lifetime, officer. 100% guaranteed.
Sunglasses. No, the lieutenant gently removes the glasses from your face, setting you free again. You're definitely not buying those. You don't tell me what to do, Kim. I like those sunglasses. No, I can't. We can't walk around with you looking like this. His hand has already risen mid-air, but stops. Okay, fine. Go ahead. If you want to look like a walking midlife crisis, then who am I to interfere? The lieutenant's reverse psychology forbery doesn't work on you. If you want to look like a mega-secret midlife crisis, that's your choice. I'm not taking any of this stuff yet.
Everything's still cool here, officer.
What's this about the clothes? Is it this? It's a check we can retry.
You keep coming back. That's good, officer.
Keep
browsing those clothes. Keep saving that economy.
Alright, shut up, Sling. Find something worth salvaging from that pile of rags. Something cold grazes your hand, synthetic and sleek, a windbreaker. Surf, it says, but also wind, summer, 100% waterproof, and sport, all in different typefaces. Endurance says, this jacket is the apex of human evolution, the moment at which man became weatherproof. Good choice, officer. Mega sporty, and it's only $4.50 for you, sir. Plus one composure, minus one shivers. Itchy pants. Never mind. Alright, so we retried that and succeeded. Now the knickknacks, or maybe it's inside here? Knickknack stand. It's a stand, it says. Who is that? Is that... Who is that?
Officer! Care to play a game with a lonely old man?
It was Renee. The jolliness is gone from Gaston's face.
Actually, never mind. It wouldn't be the same.
Where is Renee? The prick is gone, he replies, trying to smile. I can barely believe it, but he's really gone. Rest in peace. I don't know if he means that kind of gone. Hope not. Gone where? Gaston sighs and mumbles, more to himself than you. Hell, most likely. He was an absolute beep. How did he die, exactly? His angry little heart finally gave out. The dock workers found him in the guard booth this morning. Wasn't even supposed to be working for another week, but he just had to prove how tough he is. Logic says, did he feel like he has to prove he can still pull his weight? Doesn't need handouts? Guess he was about to head home, because when the dock workers found him, he was wearing civilian clothes and not the cockatoo uniform I saw him in all the time. Sometimes I thought he was wearing it just to piss me off. He smiles a sad smile. Now the joke's on him, because he's going to be buried without it. Do you think our conversation about his job pushed him to go out there? No, he replies quickly. Renee was the most stubborn man in Revachol. Nothing you or I could say would ever push him to do anything. The man was completely immovable. Empathy says he has doubts, but right now he just wants to move on and not think about it. Was he really that bad? I repeat, an absolute beep. He turns to look at the crater. Even his old army buddies wouldn't want him around. He was like an old viper. The only people who could stand to be around him were Jeannie and me. He pauses. She saw something in him when we were just kids, and his voice trembles, and she never lost sight of it. And I thought if the most beautiful being in the world can love him, then there must be something worth holding on to. Did you love him? We've hated each other our entire lives, so much in fact that... He falls silent and looks at you, eyes filling up with tears. Yes, I love that angry prick. He didn't deserve it, but I did. He wipes his eyes with a sleeve. You want to know what his last words to me were? Tell me. In Guillaume's time, you would have been shot without a trial. That's what he said to me. The old man gathers himself and wipes his eyes again. He lived a bleep and he died a bleep. Let's leave it at that. Here, something to remember your friends by. Let me see. Gaston takes the photo, hands trembling. This was 60 years ago. We all went to that parade. Young Renee looks so happy, and Jeannie... Eyes blurry with tears, he has to stop. So sad. I guess I didn't see this coming, but... It wasn't well. I'm sorry, officer, I just... He dries his eyes. Thank you. Thank you for this little memorabilia. It really means the world to me. That was nice, the lieutenant smiles. A small thing for us, but invaluable to him. He probably didn't even know Renee had the photo. Oh my god, you better get ready to... No. I offer my sincere condolences. Yes, the lieutenant nods. We are both very sorry for your loss. It is what it is. Part of life, really, he mumbles, only half listening to you. But to know from someone for 79 years and when they just gone. I just don't know anymore. About anything, really. He slowly shakes his head, then remembers your presence. But you must need something? I want to go over a few more things about Renee, if that's okay? No. Oh, no. Conclude. How sad. Can we still do this thing with the... The bool. Similar looking metal sphere. Well, we can call in about to the library. Connect me to Jamrock Public Library. Ah! 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Oh. We just have to wait a few minutes. Twelve minutes and we got it. What else should we do? Find the murder weapon. Stand by, guys. Okay, let's go to the waterfront with Kim. Check out the trajectory. Is this the mailbox? We can mail the letter here, right? On the way. The dented yellow mailbox greets you with its graffito and bullet holes in the front. I knew we'd get to use this mailbox for something. Yes, for sending mail. So logical, Kim. Drop the white envelope into the mailbox. You drop the white envelope in the darkness. It lands with a soft thud on what sounds like a couple of letters. Logic says, probably did the right thing. You can't trust that slug Everard. You know he's going to play you somehow. Then why do we do the right thing? Alright, let's go back to Everard. The lieutenant turns toward the industrial harbor. If we don't mention anything to him, he won't know before it's too late. I thought we were supposed to do this. I thought we were supposed to do that for him. Mail it. Didn't he tell us to do that? We're supposed to... Let Everard know you mailed the signatures. Mail the document. Yeah. So why does he act like Everard shouldn't know? I don't get it. Okay, this over here might be to determine the trajectory of the bullet. Get down there. Oh no, a message has been carved into the wall. Transnation Ike Nation. Well, I thought that was going to be... We could probably call Jamrock now. Library. Suna. Oh yeah, we're by it with the iceberg fridge thing. Tell me where to check them. Check boardwalk for bullet traces. Should I be zoomed all the way in? Bullet traces. So maybe not here, but further up the boardwalk. Just walking all over here. Mm. Unless, well, we already used these things. Kuno. Yeah, I've seen all that before. I'm not putting more money into this thing. Bullet traces. I don't know if it's going to show up as a little tiny green thing, like this, but small, like the money, the real. Or if it's going to be a little thing to inspect. Can I can't go back there, can I? Maybe this boardwalk, they mean? boardwalk and where? Conceptualization. It's so high already. But are we looking for bullet holes there? Check boardwalk. I don't know what we have to do with him to retry. I tried going into that. And I can't find this trash container either. And we have the book, I couldn't find that. Boardwalk. No one mean back here. I mean, literal boardwalk, there's this. Unless they mean that one. I didn't think they meant this. Damn. I really don't know. When did the church open? I mean, not the church, not the library. Jamrock Library. At 8? Or 10, I forgot. So I still got 10 minutes. 2 minutes have passed. Maybe this guy knows something. We haven't talked to him for a while.
Looking for something, Hunt? Huh? Coming to tell me to fuck off again?
You should be so lucky. Let's see if we can have any real to sell. I mean, not... Tear, to get real. The yellow roses in the window, those aren't the flowers that were left for Classier. Okay. Your bottles clunk into the machine and the money appears with a satisfying jingle. You're a richer man now. Stealing a raincoat. Is that the knickknacks thing? Cigarettes and alcohol. This is drugs.
Is this about the questions again? Because I don't really know anything.
She puts down the magazine. I don't know where on the boardwalk to check. I'm gonna stay away from that guy, because he's actually a merc. Mercenary, what we have left to do... Couldn't find Ruby. Return to the Fell Mural, I guess. Yeah, we'll do that later. Do this without Kim. The boardwalk. I don't know how to get to the island. That's something that should open up, I guess. This we have to try again. Let Everett know you mailed the signatures. I guess we can try that. Do that. Dead body. Wait, what time is it? We're still 10 minutes. Time has passed. Now time passes when we talk to people and do accomplish actual things, not buying and selling things and walking around. The dice bear fridge. That's all this stuff here, except for the body on the boardwalk. It has to do with the Raver kids. So you need to talk to Classy again. I guess we could buy those pants. You have a lot of money. Ask another about tattoos. Call Alice back. Oh. Okay. We have a few things we can do. I don't want to... Yeah. I'm going to do these other things before I return to Everard. Everard can wait. So that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.